Hi, this is Shia speaking in my room. How are you doing? Thank you so much for giving me the chance to shoot this video. And today I'd like to talk about the major challenge I see in today's architecture. Personally speaking, I believe that most of our buildings in today's society are lacking vitality, and this has alienated people from each other. So the major challenge we're facing now is how to fulfill the psychological needs of humans while providing basic living spaces. And much of my thinking on this subject grew out of my personal life experience. So my roommate Jen was diagnosed of severe depressive disorder in the November 2015. And in fact, she showed the symptoms of depression early in the September that year, but unfortunately, no one had discovered. As I recall now, I remember there were some times that I knocked on Jen's door to invite her to go to class together, but she would refuse and stated that she didn't want to go anywhere. I didn't know that Jane was suffering from all the pains until one night I accidentally found that she was being food. I was so shocked, and Jane was like a feared rabbit who ran down into my arms and was holding me so tight that her tears ran down into my collar. She was crying for help. "Please help me, please help me." She was crying, and my heart ached, but I didn't know what to do. It was a very unforgettable moment because it was the first time in my life to see a person who was so upset and frowned like a devil because of the infliction. So Jen was one of my four roommates with whom I lived with for a semester, but no one had discovered the strange action. The strange behaviors of her. And as I know that loneliness is a major trigger of depressive disorder, I couldn't help but to think and ask myself, what's wrong with our current living spaces? Why do people have a greater sense of loneliness despite the fact that we now live even closer to each other than before? Isn't there a problem with our living space? And as I remember those days of living in the remote countryside during my college year, I feel that the structure of the village there are made of vitality because the village are formed of clusters of small houses and narrow roads. It was common to receive warm greetings from locals while I was walking around the village. So, in contrast to our metropolitan, which look like big forests of steel, architecture and countryside are often less dense, while people there have much more stronger bonds among themselves. But cities, urbans, which allow people to stay even closer to each other, but live with a sense of loneliness. Architecture has now provided us much stronger shelter, but it also just triggered our emotional problems, and we are now living in a narrow with unexceptional dense population, yet we all experience of loneliness, emptiness, and even depression. Architecture in today's society has shortened the distance between peoples, yet it indirectly diminished our urge to communicate and bond with each other. And I just noticed that people who walking on the street will try to avoid those eye contacts to each other and try to become the nobody. Who be hiding in the background of metropolitan. But is this what we really want? No, I don't think so, because the basic needs of we people is to communicate and to sharing those bonds and caring from each other. So, as an architecture student, I believe that architecture should be created with warmth and vitality, and the city should be filled with warmth. And this is the challenge we're facing today. Thank you. Have a good day.